Hey, what's up, YouTube? This is Pia Skella, and today we're out here in this great city, Georgetown, Kentucky. Yeah, it's January, but this is like perfect weather. It's like 60 degrees. So we thought we'd give you a little tour of the Yuko En Japanese Garden in the city. It's a really great that we have this in this place. Our sister city relationship with the city of Tahara in Japan. And so, you know, we're just going to give you a little tour here.
There's only signs.
So, like, these gates you see here, it's very traditional, and, you know, Japanese architecture. You know, it's like what you see in, like, a Japanese castle or something. You know, big, posing, and...
Got a few signs on the sides too.
Yeah, when you walk in here,
that's where you sign it.
You know, it's like kind of it's like a really windy path. See, you know, no straight cut through way, and that's very traditional also of Japanese castles, because you know you don't want to see your you don't want your enemy to see a clear cut through path, you know, so they can't just you know go in and invade.
Also, take a look at the bamboo around here.
Yeah, great. Actually, pretty much all of these plants you see here are native to this area in Kentucky. Now, this granite thing right here, I'm not sure what it's called, but it's like kind of like a little monument thing. You see a bunch in like Japanese architecture also, like, you know, if you go into like a big house or something. And it's just cool marker, kind of. Is what this place is. You know, it's great. Now, if you walk down this path, the key to remember here is like, you know, okay, so in Japanese architecture, the key is, you know, it's all about nature. You know, you get these flowers, the trees, the cherry blossoms and stuff. And, you know, you don't build against nature. You know, you don't build against nature. You go with it. You take the natural flow of things and just, you know, express what it means. You know, be like perfect natural harmony. You know, kind of like, you know, the Shinto thing. And you know, like, you know, this big pond here. You know, just, you know, the general reflections off it. It's the big centerpiece of this place. And you know, you can be like from like the deck of the main entry place, you know, the main building, the pavilion there, which we'll touch on later. We have right here a nice little stone block, and you know, just a little pottery workshop that you know we like. Just, you know, because, you know, in Japan, it's nice just to have, you know, everything on site. Just, like, you know, again, great place to just, you know, express your craft out in, like, you know, nature. Now, as we go up here, this is going to take us to, like, a little tea house, like, you know, where you have, like a tea ceremony or something. Excuse me, we're just gonna go this way because how wood it ends. But, like, you know, again, thinking about like the stone walk through there, as you see, you know, you're surrounded by all the trees, you know, it's probably like a really nice night or something, you know, probably, you know, got like, you know, geisha or something, you know, attending to you. And it's just, it's kind of the Japanese tradition. It's like, you know, back in like the Heian period, you know, when, you know, the aristocrats had like, you know, big kind of place. And, you know, you get kind of like feel like you're out in nature here. And it's like, you know, you might have like a tatami mat or something like that. But it's just, like, tea is, you know, very traditional, very central to Japan and, you know, the culture. And so it's nice that we have places like this. Again, just kind of usual show, like the back side of the workshop and go back over towards the main pavilion. I have to say, this is like, you know, pretty great weather to be out doing something like this. I mean, I know it's not in season, like the flowers and trees aren't blooming, but you know, it's cool. Just, you know, nice place to, you know, come every once in a while and you just get the, like, the feeling of nature and, you know, like you see there, just, you know, like the big kind of like an adobe field, it just blends in really well. And you know, you got like a vine lattice up there, you know, like this. So now we're gonna come back over towards, like, you know, the main area, and this is like the walk towards, like, you know, the main pavilion. Then you see, like, you know, this bridge right here across this nice little cut through. You know, it's all painted red and stuff because, you know, red is just very traditional to Japan. You know, again, you know, very great with the cherry blossom season and stuff. And the key is, you know, it's all kind of like in harmony with nature. It's just, you know, kind of like the way things were meant to be. Now, we walk over here and try to give you like a nice shot inside of there. You know, very clean, very open. And like, the key is, like, you know, you got all natural surroundings. And so if it was like a really nice day, gonna have all these sliding doors open or something.
What about this modern door here?
Yeah.
This, again, looks like, an old door.
The red door there. And so, just ignore that. Great place. Sorry for the noise.
We'll edit that out.
Kind of, you know, the rain dripping down this. I mean, it's probably not as much like a Japanese thing in particular, but, you know.
Thing. Dripping down into the rock water, so it has to be.
But it's just, it brings out like that natural feel. But, you know, it's like, you know, you see like this, you know, the surroundings, you know, you got like the pond and all the trees and flowers. Just, you know, sit down, you know, meditate like this. You know, pretty big Buddhist tradition.
Dang it, it's not focused.
You know, take in your natural surroundings and just, you know, just meditate. Feels great.
Another door.
And so what we're coming to now, it's like a stone garden, place.
Here's another
you
chain.
You know, little, little ones, big shout out to like a Boy Scout trooper around here that put that together for us. But now, as you see here, this is like, you know, again, great place for just meditating, you know. You have like just the gravel, you know, the adobe, like, and just the stones. Just very simple, but you know, it has a lot to when you think about it. And you know, the way it's raked, that's done on purpose. And like, you know, it's just, you know, that way. Now, you know, ordinarily in Japan, you just, you know, have like a nice place here, like a balcony where you just sit, and you know, usually like you wouldn't have like a railing like you have here, but you know, it's just great that we have this in this great city of ours, and you know, it's just a nice thing. So we're going to come back here, and we're just, you know, this is just like a little path around like the rest of the garden. You know, you got some nice, you know, little, you know, statue here, and, you know, big open lawns. But, you know, the key about these paths are, you know, they're not, like, straight, like you'd see like an English garden or something. You don't always know where they're going to go. And, you know, sometimes you have trees in the way, like, you know, you saw back there. So, just, again, just, you know, nature, expressivity, you know, human's harmony with nature, not its own nature. And, you know, that's what I love about, you know, Asian culture and, you know, just that Europeans seem to not really caught on to as much, but, like, you know, like this right here, just little, you know, little shed here, and just a nice stone walk up to here, just hanging out with natural steps, you know, nothing crazy, but, you know, it's just, you know, a nice little place to go, you know, long bench, you just sit here and, you know, just meditate. Feels great. Again, you know, great that we have a place like this. So, we're gonna go back around. I think I'll probably get to cut this into two segments or something.
Well, I'll get another view of the shed.
But, like, you know, since we're in Japan, we'd probably go out for, you know, for acres and acres. And, you know, like a little stone ornament, you know, it's nothing too fancy. It's just kind of, you know, just kind of there. And it's just...
looks cool.
It's cool. And so, come back around this way. This is going to kind of lead us to like a little side pond. The main pond.
Yeah, and again with like the trees, just emphasizing that nature is very important to Japan's culture.
Yeah, and I think that's like, that's great. Just, you know, the trees. Actually, you know, like Shinto legend, I think I heard this once, like, you know, they believe like, you know, their genesis story, their creation. It's like, you know, humans climb down from the heavens to the earth, you know, among the trees. Just goes to show how much, like, their architecture and their philosophy and stuff just kind of blends in. And,
yeah, I can fact check that.
Yeah. I mean, not crazy about being too accurate, but it's just, you know, again, it's just like you got, like, this place and, you know, this bridge is kind of arching.
Yeah, during the spring and the summer, they turn something on and the water flows down.
Yeah, and, you know, this would just be like a nice place just to sit here and think about things.
Yeah.
So we're going to go on this way. Excuse my cameraman here.
Yeah, sorry.
This is great. But just, like, you know, in season, this would all be blooming, and it would look great. And so, you know, it's great that we have a place like this. And, you know, you just go, like, you know, just a corner of the garden or something, and, like, kind of be outside. And, like, it's just... I just love Japanese culture. I just, you know, hope someday I get to go to Japan or something.
That's why I wish I was still in Japanese. Yeah.
So, you know, back here, we're going to take a little, like, off path.
Uh-oh.
Just, like, you know, we'll bench out here, out in the trees, and, you know, getting to kind of have those ornaments here and there. You know, and there's like one back over here. As you can see,
focus. It won't focus, but that's okay.
You know, there's like another one back over here. But, you know, it just it looks nice. You know.
Oh yeah, that ornament over there.
Just, you know, imagine some night and, like, you know, fireflies and stuff are all crickets are all chirping. You know. you know, probably have like the light of like a torch or something. Just, you know, picture that for a sec. And then, you know, you have that little waterfall.
Let's go next to it.
Yeah, this one's running. Even though it's January, but you know, the trickling sound of the water, just, you know, stop, think about that for a sec. Yeah. Again, just, you know, coming back around. This is a great place. I think it's great that, you know, our city could put this together. Big shout out to our sister city in Japan. It's Tahara. You know, big shout out to our world language department at the high school. Big shout out to, you know, our Japanese fans and teachers and all. And Christopher Connor, Nate Patton, y'all. It's great that, you have the chance to teach us this stuff and just show us, you know, this kind of stuff. And it's great that I get to have the experience. And, like, I hope you guys have gotten to have this too. So we're going to stop this in just a sec. I just want to take all back around to the front. Just, you know, big overview here. I'm just gonna, you know, give y'all a little panorama shot, just, you know, show y'all that, you know, this, you know, big gift that we could have this in Kentucky, of all places. Thanks. I hope you enjoyed. If y'all like, I'm gonna make some more videos like this sometime, maybe. Hope y'all enjoy this. This has been PS Killa and my cameraman Luigi the 13th. You want to give a shout?
Peace out. Shout out to me.
Yeah. Thanks. Peace.